What is going on, listen, Death of a Demon here, and I'm back once again with some more Sherlock Holmes, The Devil's Daughter. That's right, guys, and I feel like I haven't played this game enough in the past couple days when it came out the 10th. It's already the 13th, and I haven't only done one episode. That is sad. I got caught up with Mirrors of the Catalyst and Minecraft Story Mode and all that stuff. But don't worry, guys, I will be switching off between this and Mirrors of the Catalyst for now. But if you do enjoy this video, drop a like to let me know and subscribe, because that always helps. And I love when I get likes on my videos and comments. Don't forget to comment. And now let's do this, guys. Right now, we're on the first case of the game, Freytel. Right now, pay a visit to Lord Marsh. That's where we left off last episode after our daughter came here. Kaylee or Kennedy or whatever the hell her name was. Now, in the options... surroundings. Shut the hell up! In the options menu, the gameplay options menu, I switched it. So now when I fast travel to, like, let's say, the Lord Marsh's house, it shows me in the cab instead of the stupid loading screen. See? And I can still look at stuff, like I said right now. English coat of arms of the Marsh family. So they were a very powerful family, still are, I guess you could say. And I just, now we can see my beautiful Sherlock Holmes butthole driving in my carriage. Ignore that I just said that, I did not mean that. Come on. So yeah, I didn't like the normal loading screen, it's just kind of boring. It kind of just shows, like, you know, loading screen. So it's not that cool, man. This might load a little bit slower, because, I mean, there's stuff on screen. I hope not. Please load faster. Faster. There we go. So we are here at Lord Marsh's house. We are Heather. Heather all day.
Holmes, about Caitlin.
Caitlin, yes. That's her name.
She has grown up, hasn't she? Don't you think it's time to tell her?
To tell her what, Watson?
Yeah, tell her what,
about
Watson?
Her father.
Never. Absolutely never. Do you hear me?
Holmes, you were responsible for the death of her father. You owe her the truth. She is old enough.
Wait.
I would lose her. Can't you see that? She must never know. Watson, is that clear?
I thought I was
her
dad.
Won't and can't happen.
I thought I was her daddy.
Let's get inside.
Yeah, bust in through the door.
Come in, please.
Hello, sir.
Good day, gentlemen. Welcome to my home. How may I help you?
Good day to you, Lord Marsh. My name is Sherlock Holmes, and this is my friend and colleague, Dr. Watson.
That's right. All right. Character. He looks sick. I guarantee his face is one thing. Right? Yep. Sickly eyes. Feels unwell, lack of sleep. I'd say feels unwell. Right? I don't see anything up here. Ooh, that's something, I had a feeling. Blanket, he is ill. Ooh, he could be hiding something. Yeah, we're gonna go with ill, but I think, yeah. M for Marcius, a man of wealth, whatever. There's a lot of stuff to figure out about this guy. Painkiller. Yes, I told you he was ill. Strong painkiller. This guy's wealthy. Lord Marsh's personal assistant. Hold up. I will say that. I want to read what it says. I accidentally hit skip. I didn't mean to put that. Damn it. Damn it, man, I don't want to put that. Yep, I got all of them right for that, you know, scenario. Member of a hunting club, physician, yeah, he's sick. I told you he was sick. Damn it, I meant to, like, exit so I could read the notebook. Alright, Reuben Fisher. Reuben Fisher's a young man of 25 and already a confident physician. He is well-educated, mannered, and member of a hunting club. His clothes indicate he is financially wealthy. Reuben Fisher is not the only physician. He is not only a physician. He is also Lord Marsh's personal assistant. Now, Lord Marsh is a wealthy man who holds a high position in society, indicated by his expensive clothes and valuable gold ring. He has dedicated his life to helping the poor. He is ill, therefore, he is covered with a blanket, despite the fact that it's autumn or something, quite warm inside the room.
I hope we're not disturbing you. You are with your physician?
Yes, this is Dr. Reuben Fisher. But no, please, I'm intrigued by your visit, Mr. Holmes.
I'm glad to hear it. The last thing I'd wish is to upset the patient. Lord Marsh, can I just say that I admire all of your efforts in assisting the poor of London?
Yes. It is a war that we must fight on our streets and now too from my home. You must surely have noticed those bags full of items, clothing and books for the unfortunate.
That is inspiration. At my own humble level, I too try my best to support those in need. I thought perhaps that I could be of some assistance.
I don't see why not. I already have the valuable assistance of Dr. Fisher, who happens to be my personal physician.
Forgive me, Lord Marsh. You're looking very pale. Might I offer Dr. Watson's assistance?
That is kind of you, but I feel confident that I can provide Lord Marsh with the care that he requires.
How long have you been like this, my lord?
I'm fine, Dr. Watson. Don't fuss. It's only influenza. I'll be better in a few days. I can feel it already.
Painkiller.
In that case, why are you taking such powerful painkillers?
Excuse me, what do you mean?
Mr. Holmes is referring to the pills on your table.
Yeah, bitch.
I'm sorry, but that's a medical confidentiality.
It's curious. Your face seems familiar to me, Doctor. Oddly, I'm associating it with Whitechapel.
Well done. You are right. I do occasionally frequent a few hostelries over there, would you believe it?
I do believe
it,
sir.
I am a drinker. But there, dressed as a working man, I can approach the other fellows to see if they might be interested in a special job.
A special job? May I ask what you're referring to?
Certainly. Since Lord Marsh began his special education program in 1889, he foresaw that such people would need an occupation of some kind. And
so,
with or without education, we propose these opportunities to work with Lord Marsh. It offers the less fortunate a chance to help make London a better place.
That's remarkable.
Yes, indeed. In order to truly see, one requires vision, yes, but also insight. And Lord Marsh has believed this since he was a child.
AC.
Oh, Dr. Fisher makes it all sound so romantic. Let's close this topic.
Why? You just had to hide, bitch?
Despite my title, yes. I have to share my home with these bags full of food for the poor.
A provision dealing with the paupers of Whitechapel. Last year, three orphans were put through medical college.
Wow, that's actually pretty cool.
Thanks to Lord Marsh and the special education program, a great many poor people will have a second chance in life.
Lord Marsh hunting
with his friends.
Alright. My dear comrades, Lord Collins and Lord Harrington. If it wasn't for this godforsaken English malady, I'd be with those rapscallions right now.
All in due time, my lord.
Some papers. Document with seal. Why is he not finding it weird with searching around? Dear Lord Marsh, here is a list of selected participants for the special education program in October. It looks like a very promising event. I'm looking forward to Patrick Tanner, Thomas Kelly, John Strubbridge, William Thatcher, Reginald Staple. Hang on.
I've never heard of this man. John Strubbridge, I've seen this name before. It was on a missing persons poster.
Yeah. See, it's been so long since I played. It's been 3 days. Forgot all about that.
I can't quite work it out. Do you have any ideas to the number of people who might owe you their lives?
Oh, don't embarrass me, Mr. Holmes. But indeed, these people have become like a family to me.
That would be a very large family, I imagine.
Yes, the list would be longer than any of your short stories. As for how large, well, Fisher is the one who keeps record.
Might we take a glance at the list?
I regret that is impossible. It is confidential. I stand firm upon that point, Mr. Holmes.
I quite understand. We'll most certainly send a donation towards your educational program. I shall take my leave then. I thank you both, and I wish you all the very best, gentlemen.
Likewise, Mr. Holmes.
You don't seem sick. You'll be fine. What is B? A pair Find a pair of related clues and they will form a deduction. Red color signifies that. Alright. No. There, up. Doesn't make no sense, man. Alright. The special job mentioned by George Hurt is not connected to the special education program. George Hurt's special job and Lord Marsh's special are somehow connected. I'd say so. Nope. Alright. Well, I'd say that's it then. I'd say they're connected, so. But this game requires you to actually choose, you know, which side you go for, and then this game is really hard, and I'll actually. Crimes and Punishments was pretty hard. I'm just gonna keep searching.
It's shut tight.
Damn it. Case solved, there's a dead guy in there.
Hey, the paupers of Lambeth Workhouse.
Lambeth Workhouse.
Humanitarian aid for an orphanage.
Such a good man. Oh, can I talk to Watson quick? Watson, I'm coming for you.
I'm intrigued by the special education program.
I didn't ask your opinion, but thank you.
It appears that Lord Marsh spent a great deal of his money on aiding the... I've never seen so many provisions for the poor, and certainly not in a lord's house.
Alright. Alright, what is next in this case? Alright. Alright, so that says he offers a disguise, or adopted one, I should say. Explore Hertz Hovel on 12 Dorset Street, room E. Hertz House, is that it? Is that what I'm going for? I don't understand, guys. I don't understand. But this game is awesome. I just wish I played more. It's just that I stuffed up on all those other series because they're just important. Hopefully in this episode we can end this case and move on to the next one. That would be great. That way, you know, two episodes of case, and that's quite long enough to solve a case. That's like an hour, about, depending on how long they make the episode. So let's see. Alright, can I do this while it loads? Yes, I can. Alright. We good? Yeah, alright, we good. We can get the hell out now, guys. Get the hell out of this damn truck. Alright, this is the wrong place, but what was the address? Hurst Hovel on 12 Dorset Street, room E. Isn't that this house? E, yeah. Alright. Investigate disappearance of Tom's father, George Hurst. Something's not right here. Something's not right. Must have missed something.
I won't disturb Lord Marsh without a reason.
Let's go here then, I'm assuming. Oh, that's right. I could just walk down there. I didn't need the loading screen. Damn it. Oh, guys, I didn't think about that. Can I talk to someone down here? I don't see anything. Oh, the music becomes so distorted.
Dump the bosses off your backs.
Huh. Anywhere else to go? Whitechapel? Oh, I don't think that was there before, was it? Was it there? Oh, I think it was. I think if I go over here, though, this is where I just came from, right? Yeah. Alright. Ah, oh, shoot. Damn, I don't know where to go. I don't know where to go. Oh, maybe if I talk to Tom. That might be it. 12, and then E, which is right up here. Left. Father, Yes, I...
Mr. Holmes, do you have any news about my father?
Tom, not so fast. I wanted to ask you if you remember your father mentioning anything about a special education program.
An education program? No, he only talked about a special job.
What's this box, Tom?
Oh, yeah. I just found it, Mr. Holmes. It was ever so well hidden. I've no idea why.
Well done, my boy. It could prove very helpful.
Tom, you told your father. We're going to go with that.
This oil can also be used on weapons.
Hunting. Aha!
Wolfjack. Looks like a military badge. A ramrod. Being a rifle.
Key.
Tom, does your father own a rifle?
A rifle? No. If he had, he would have shown it me.
I'm sure that he wouldn't have shown it you. I need to find this rifle.
Alright, something's hidden here. A key was found in Tom's house. Examine the box. Alright, where's this rifle?
This scrap of cloth was used to oil a firearm.
Yep.
Tom, does your father have any other property?
No. Well, at least I don't think so.
I have to take Toby. He'll take a sniff of the oil, and we'll find that rifle.
Oh, hell yeah, Toby, I'm coming. Alright. So, fetch Toby out to 221 B, Baker Street. I meant to look it up before the end of last episode. Sherlock Holmes was actually, like, this real guy who had a dog, Toby, Watson. But I know he was a real person, I'm pretty sure. But, like, you know? Like, if this game is actually specific, then I wonder if there's a case like this. That'd be kind of cool. The Devil's Daughter. I wonder if I have to fight the devil and then, like, punch him in the face. I already did that and got out of hell. Just didn't do it on my channel. I don't like that game. I like Saints Row 3 and being low. I don't like 4. 4 was horrible, in my opinion. As a longtime fan of the series, you know, sorry, I like realistic games. So people got to play Battlefield 1 yesterday. That's so awesome. I wish I could play it. Toby, where the hell are you?
Come on, Toby. It's time for you to earn your keep.
Sorry, bitch. Wait, do I have to play as a member in Crime and Punishments? Stop barking.
Watson, I prefer to visit Lord Marsh. I'm worried about the condition of his health.
So what the hell am I doing?
I prefer to visit Lord Marsh.
So what am I doing? Oh, do I have to go to here? I think I have to go there. Yeah, see, Toby's with me now. That dog is freaking fat. I love Toby, guys. He's so cute. I didn't remember his name at the beginning. But he is really cute. And this game is really awesome. Sherlock Holmes, the Devil's Daughter. I wonder where they got the name for the game. Classic of Motherhood and Parentcraft. Why are you reading that book, Holmes? You make no sense, bro. That's right, bitch, I made dollars. Come on, load. I think it loads faster if you don't have the cinematic up.
Search, Toby, search.
Aha! I just opened the door with my dog brain. Careful going down the stairs. How am I playing as Toby? This is weird. Isn't he a bloodhound or whatever where they smell really well? If I don't get hit by a carriage. Two ways, but this seemed like a better way.
It's only a garden shed. Let's go on.
Sorry, man. Got distracted, asshole. Smell of oil's pretty strong, bro. Hope you do this yourself, Holmes. Just the garden. So I'm assuming. This must be it. Hermit's lair. I got an achievement. So something's down here. The other way. Oh crap. Stop. What am I doing?
Pile of rubbish.
Alright.
Just some old things.
Right.
Old thing.
Yep.
Ordinary storage.
So it's this one. Yeah, it's definitely the one that's protected.
Tom's photograph. Let's try to get inside.
Alright, use the correct lock pits. To lift the lock plate. What the hell? What am I trying to do?
There's no space for this lockpick.
Oh, I see. I see how it works now. All right.
Oh. News clippings on Lords in the education program. Why are they here?
Lord Marsh's association with his friends Lord Harrington and Lord Collins is the co-founder of Special Education Program, an assistant of the poor to build better lives. These two gentlemen surely help lift the level of our struggling society. Alright. Look at that. There's a pen. Can we... Oh, and on there's a note. Dear Tom, if you're reading this letter, then it means I'm dead. I'm so sorry that things had to end up this way, but I had no other choice. You have to know that. You're a very smart boy, and I'm so proud of you. I hope one day you'll understand and you'll forgive me, son. I love you so much. Don't despair. Try to be happy, and you'll grow up to be a man someday. Sooner than you think, you won't be alone. Me and your mom, ma'am, will be looking over you. Well, actually, I think this is ma'am. Whatever. Heaven, your father.
Let's compare this list with the evidence that we found earlier.
This is stupid.
This
weird.
Is the list of selected participants for October's special education program. According to All this right. poster, John Strobridge is missing. Let's compare them with people from Hearst documents.
Alright, Edgar Bristol, Daniel Smith, Edgar Evany, Edgar Bristol, Garfield Little, Harold Davies, Henry, John Strobridge.
This man appears in
right
both
there.
Documents.
Alright, but there's an X. John Thomas, so, alright. Orson R. Patrick. And then missing, Reginald. They're all the ones that are X'd out. Oh, it's not the one, not D. Robert Taylor. Thomas Kelly, William Thatcher.
All the people in Marsh's document are marked and dated in George Hurst's files.
Must be people they're killing or something. Daniel Jones, right? What is this? Dear George, I do understand you and it's so sad. Same as you, I can't find a job, not even the smallest thing. My children have nothing to eat. When I try to find anything, the boxes just say that they don't want wounded people. working for them. Our military service means nothing. Our country used us in the war, but now it has abandoned us. Nobody cares. Your friend, Jack. Sorry, Jack. Sorry to hear that. Nowadays, you definitely get some.
This case must have been full of cartridges.
Alright, I had an analogy type thing to make over here. Farewell, missing. No return. George Hirschner stood no chance of returning from a special over there for George Hirschner's welfare, but didn't give it to Tom. There's a chance he that it, I'd say that. Is that everything? Newspaper. I don't really know. Yeah, that's everything it seems. So, we made that analogy, we connect them together, so... But I already read this. Oh, by Her Royal Majesty Queen Victoria of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Ireland, I, Frederick Russell Birmingham, Major of the British Army, declared the country extends its gratitude to George Hurston, Honorable Soldier of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Ireland, for his valiant military service. British Army hereby awards him with the Distinguished Conduct Medal and retires him due to the injury sustained while on duty, Major Frederick Russell Burnham. I'm assuming there's a rifle in here, or he took it with him. Right? No. There's a map.
A map of Epping Forest.
Don't tell me we're going to Epping Forest. You guys remember how the game started?
On the stand.
Rifle. Spoiler alert, if you weren't, here for the first episode, you should definitely check it out. Imagination, talent, visualize objects, events.
There was a rifle.
Yeah.
George Hurst took it with him.
Exactly what I said. So yeah, if you weren't here for the very beginning of the game, spoiler alert, he got shot in the back. Showed it. Violence. Your special job is associated with violence. Well, I'd freaking say so. So far, we haven't made any connections, which is kind of disappointing. Do I have another one to make? No? Ah. Missing. All participants of the S group from the special could be missing. Oh, I see. So all the ones from the S group. See, I didn't read that when I was doing it. Oh, I have another connection. What? And then paper. Oh, alright. George Hurst was interested in the special, but nothing more. Just collected information about the paupers and the lords involved. I'd say that. Mr. Hurst knew. George Hurst knew about some of the people who had gone missing from the special. Right. Is that everything? Right. There we go. Boom! That's what we needed. Wound. That? Nope. Alright. Damn, we have a lot to do now. Thank God, guys. We finally figured some stuff. I'm gonna keep the episode going. I know it's hitting towards my average Let's Play, you know, mark. But we have to keep it going. We have to keep it going. It's just getting interesting. She's also getting interesting. Is Toby okay outside? Better not be taking a poop in the grass. Toby, I would smack you for taking a poop. Did you take a poop? Did you take a poop? No? Alright. So how about we sneak into their house? Let's see. Our objective. Sneak into the Lord Marsh's house, find out more about that. Yep, explore. Yep. And alright, so the only thing we can do is sneak in. So let's go. We are sneaking in. We are freaking awesome, guys. We are Sherlock homeos. We are homies of all the people. We are saving the day once again. But I really hope we don't have to go to that forest, because if we do, that's probably where we got shot, because it was showing a snowy forest. And I was running through it, and I got hit with a rifle. So I'm going to assume that's what happened. Hopefully not. Because then it said, what did it say? 48 hours earlier? Or, like, a day earlier? Or, like, what? It said something. Something earlier. And it wasn't long. So you never know. You never know, mate.
Holmes, what are you doing here? What are you planning? A mission of my own. You must play the role of the conscientious doctor while I sneak inside Marsh's house. That's the only way of helping little Tom.
I thought I was sneaking up against... Oh, Jesus, lad, man, lad.
This is not the best way to sneak in.
Well, don't correct me then, asshole. You're not even being sneaky. How is this sneaky? I'm sitting up with a foot and a half above the damn bush. Just walking down the side of the building. Ta-da. I think we have to go through this window.
The window is firmly shut.
Alright, of course we have to go through the back door. Alright. So, apparently... Alright, got this right. That should be good for this. And I'd say number two. How do I... remove that guy. There's a slide in between the bars, and depending on the height and thickness of the bar, you have to actually adjust it. So, depending on how big the rod is, to actually flip it up.
How can I help you?
I came to visit Lord Marsh.
What for?
I would very much like to see Lord Marsh, if you please.
You're so clumsy. Can you please not...
I have to visit Lord Marsh and offer him my services.
Fisher, please allow Dr. Watson to enter.
I love you guys. Stop it.
Good job, Watson.
All right. There's a painting over here hanging crookedly. Fingerprints.
Let's see how hard to crack this safe.
Doctor, it appears that you were impatient to pay me another visit.
Indeed. Will you allow me to examine you? A second opinion, so that the great Lord Marsh does not become the late Lord Marsh.
Well, since you put it that way, very well.
Shall I retire to your office, Lord Marsh?
No, please, Doctor. I insist that you stay. I shall need your assistance.
Will you break anything else?
I'll try my best.
Do I have to run? I'm confused. Do I have to hide?
Mr. Holmes? What are you doing here?
Oh, I was supposed to hide.
Will you break anything else?
I'll try my best.
There we go. I like how it's showing it from like a first person perspective. So cool. Alright. Now let's try and crack the safe. Rotate the safe dial. Area of clear sound. What? Kind of confused. What? I think, like, I match it up with that. Alright. Oh. Video games teach you how to break into saves. What if one's louder? There we go. So this... I so admire all of these poppers. They seem to be such... they seem to me such a breath of fresh air. Meeting with them is such a pleasure, and they are so smart. Not like this. Not like us, my men. Perhaps it is they should have lords and simple commanders. Shut up, Lord Harrington, you faggot.
November 7th. This means that the meeting is planned for today.
Dear Lord Marsh, November 7th, our meeting starts. It runs the notes. I have attached a map to the letter so you may find the place easily. I would like to go back in and search, please. Oh, that's it. Alright. So we have map fragment. Alright.
Lord Marsh is a keen hunter.
Yeah, I'd say so. No, go here first. This might be a special jobs folder. What? Alright. Dear Lord Marsh, thanks for the special education program. My life has been changed completely. I didn't know how to thank you, so I picked you this flower. Aha! Hold up. Dear Lord Collins, it is clear to me that we can learn a great many things about running the Empire from those whom we trample underfoot. These same people whom we leave destitute and starving in the shadows of our own cities are home abroad, Lord Marsh. And this, and then there's a box under it. To this day, and by my estimation, the special education programme, that's what I think it says every time, has saved over 200 individuals from the gutter and elevated them to the help form and support the critical foundations of the prosperous empire. This is largely thanks to the wisdom and foresight of Lord Marsh, who is the most progressive and wise politician. He's carried out a great deal of work in his field, this field, whilst ignoring the critics and any hindrance from his arrogant colleagues who are so set in their ways. I feel like he's coming. Assuming that's everything. I don't see anything else, guys. And gals. It's all off. It's time to go.
I'd suggest that your current weakness is perhaps more than a simple case of influenza.
Where might your companion be, Dr. Watson?
Yep, that's consumption right there.
Oh, he's busy poking his nose into other people's business, I'm sure.
Yep, he has consumption.
My lord, I'm sorry to interrupt, but I must remind you about your meeting.
Is it already
time? How was that noise?
My apologies, Dr. Watson, but we are expected elsewhere. Might we offer you a lift?
You are going out. I'm not sure that's wise in your condition.
I value your opinion, but misery never rests, and I am needed.
Well, do please take good care of yourself, Lord Marsh. I'll send you my diagnosis, Dr. Fisher.
Thank you, Dr. Watson. Farewell.
All right, that's just weird. All right, so what the hell are we doing now? Oh, so I didn't try to distract him from whatever noise that was. I just took his thing so we could, you know, analyze it in the chem lab. That says these need to be looked up, apparently. These need to be looked up in the archives, and this needs to be an analysis. Because that's how the other game played out. So, hope you guys are enjoying the video so far. This has been a great episode. We're getting into the case. I love detective games. I said this in the last episode. My favorite video game of all time, all history, was L.A. Noire. By Rockstar Games. Oh, that was such a great game. It was so perfected. I played it like 1,000 times over. It was amazing. Just loved it so much. All right. Let's search
Holmes,
the archives.
Come here. This is serious.
Why?
Watson, what are you doing at my table?
I just need to check one thing about Lord Marsh.
Okay, sir. His handkerchief.
My intuition tells me that Lord Marsh is hiding something about his disease. His cough, in addition to his fever and his usage of strong painkillers,
leads me to believe that he is seriously ill.
So
let's study it more closely. With tiny drops of blood. I could take a sample and examine it under the microscope.
So I need like a rag or something. Alright.
Let us apply chemicals to color the sample.
Alright, so I need an eyedropper first.
Let us apply chemicals to color the sample.
Oh, I thought I had to... No. Oh, yeah, I do. That's what I was saying. Boop. No, oh, okay, so we have to go one at a time. I see. Figured we would just, you know, put one, but no, we have to put all three. We're literally making it lighter. That would have been perfect, what it looked like before. Food coloring has blood from his consumption. No. That's what a lot of people died from.
Let's
back
examine
then.
The colored sample under the microscope.
All of Edgar Allan Poe's women's. You know what I mean? Simiston. Aha!
Mycobacteria. It appears that Lord Marsh is seriously ill.
That's not good. I'm telling you, it's consumption, guys.
Holmes, this is no longer a laughing matter. It is just as I feared Lord Marsh is suffering from tuberculosis.
You don't say.
Yes, I do say. And Holmes, he will die if he is not transferred to a sanatorium as soon as possible.
And yet both Lord Marsh and Dr. Fisher are doing their best to hide this fact. How interesting.
But why?
Why indeed, Watson?
Oh, but... Oh, dear God. You don't think... that Lord Marsh contracted tuberculosis while aiding the poor. How terrible. I have a commitment that I can't possibly cancel. Holmes, during my absence, please be extremely careful. This disease is highly contagious. And remember that we have women at home.
Not really a woman. I mean, it's like a 12-year-old girl. It's not even my kid.
Thank you, Miss
Alice. How is she here?
Until later.
I'll see you soon, Caitlin.
Where have you been?
Our neighbor lent me a book. She is so kind. I think she likes you.
She probably shouldn't.
How is your investigation going?
It's going. Dracula?
Yes. It's forbidden reading at my boarding school. Did you know?
Well, well.
Just a freaking vampire. I watched a cartoon in school.
Thrilling.
You read like half a page. Stupid people. Alright, now we need to search the, damn it, shift tab and all the time. Stupid keyboard. Whatever. Alright. Now we need to search this crap. Alright. Military badge. Wolfjack.
That's not the one.
I don't understand how to do this, man. History. Aha.
That's not the.
Damn it. Botany.
That's not the one.
I don't understand how to do this, guys. I always screw this up.
That's not the one I need.
Oh, look.
That's not the one.
Alright, military badge.
That's not the one.
Ah! Medicine. Technology.
That's
none of those.
Not the one I
84, so sort of 85.
That's
not the one.
Alright, skip it. Yes, I'm bad at this. Was used to describe. Whatever, I don't care. I know I'm bad at it, screw it. What are we trying to do? Lovat Scout. I literally just spam the crap out of him until I get it. George Harrison belonged to Lovat Scout's marksman unit. Alright. That was obvious. Hunting in that club. That was a deer hunting club. His friends are skillful and experienced hunters. And that's it. Alright. Getting a lot of things from this. Now, I don't know exactly what this is. Let's see. Runs is a point, pinpoint on the map. Architecture. Maybe. Oh, I didn't even know this was a section. Map fragment. All right. Oh, it goes down a little bit. It has a list. Oh no, it doesn't.
That's not the one I need.
No, I know. I just wanted to see if it would tell me a picture. What the hell would this be under? Alright, again, let's do skip. I'm so damn bad at this. Crimson Oak is a strange and mysterious tree that grows in... Oh, so that would have been a tree thing. So it would have been under, like, growing or whatever. It grows in Epping Forest. Yep. Okay, this is a problem. That's going to be a problem.
Cranston's Oak is in Epping Forest. That's the place indicated on George Hurst's map.
Yep, alright. So I'm assuming that's where we're going. We're going to die. Life is hard, you know. Right, oh, search the map. Oh, the map on the wall over here?
Let's try to find the place from the hand drawn.
How the hell am I supposed to just find this? I thought Epping Forest was up here. Yeah. Cranston Oak. I don't see that anywhere. Damn it. Down here. Cranston Oak. Black boy. Alright, so this is a forest area. Let's just skip it for the freaking sake of time.
Drat. I'll need to hurry if I want to find out what's going on at the forest.
Does he come here very often?
He helps occasionally in some of my cases. Why do you ask?
I'd like to talk to him.
Talk to him?
Father, back at school there are only girls to talk to, and they are so boring.
I'm sure
Wiggins has lots of exciting stories to tell about his life in London. It would be so romantic.
The hell do you know about romance? Let's sit.
Caitlin,
yeah,
you know that Wiggins hasn't had the most fortunate life.
That only makes him more interesting.
Oh, Kate.
I'll leave you alone now.
Nah, leave me alone, Caitlin, you stupid. Map, an invitation. Meeting! Woohoo! Kapuya. There we go. We're starting to find places in this damn case. That is right. Alright, so should we do it this video? Yeah, might as well. It's gonna be so long. so, like, epic forest, man. Hopefully the case ends soon so we can move on to the next one. I thought I'd be able to finish the case in this episode, but no. Yep, this is where it gets shot. And this is the part. I already got shot. Who the hell is it? What's happening?
Let's see how long you can stay alive.
Oh, I see. See what's happening. So I have to get away from him at the same time as taking cover. Come on, die. This way. I dodged it. I'm gonna die. Oh, I'm gonna die. This is actually really hard. Shut the hell up, bitch. I've been just playing Xbox all day. Expect me to be skinny? We'd be right, because I'm skinny as hell. No, it's gonna be your blood, bitch. It's gaining on me. I die. I died, right? Yeah, it's actually really hard, guys. Damn it, I always run right into it. So clearly I interrupted something. You can't just be getting shot at. Jesus, man. You need to be safe. Shooting at people is not a good way to make friends, asshole. Alright, that way. I thought thorny bushes would be so much easier. Bitch. I don't even know where I hit you, bro. Literally skimmed me, faggot. Guys are some good shots, I'm gonna be honest with you. Shooting through rocks. Where is he? Up your mother's butthole, that's where I am right now. Knee deep in your mother's face. Bitch. The hell off me, I'm Sherlock Holmes, bitch. I'll find you and I'll kill you, don't worry. No.
You're a clumsy one, aren't you?
Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no. That was bad. Leave me, Sherlock. Ow! Oh shit, Sherlock. Just take cover. Oh no, they're catching up. Now they're starting to get a little too close for comfort. I'm gonna die. Maybe this way. Oh. Guys, this is actually insane. This is pretty fucking cool. Why are they trying to kill me? I wish we had some context here.
He was poor. This man was killed recently. The body is still warm.
Uh oh, is this our... Bitch, I don't know who you think you're shooting at. I'm sure I'm not effing Holmes. Alright. Yep, this isn't good. I was so far ahead. Sherlock, if you can hear me, keep running. You guys really suck at shooting, actually. Oh no, they got me. Yep, they got me. Damn it, guys, you're so close. Bear trap. Alright, go. Now let's make a bear trap up here. Oh, that's right, bitch. I just used it for cover for a quick sec. I was standing still and I was losing tons of stamina. Slide. Shit. The rock slide would have got me farther away, but the car would have got hurt or something. Couldn't use detective mode. What do you mean?
I like to call this the Swamp of Death!
No, what are you doing? Oh no. Guys, these controls are really shitty, I'm not gonna lie. For this type of scenario in the game, this is actually really shitty controls. I'd like to shoot you in your asshole, but that isn't happening, bitch. Come on. This way. Come on! This. And then, oh no! Ugh. Oh, there's a house! Stupid shit like that pisses me off.
You scampering little rat.
I don't know where I'm supposed to be getting. There's nowhere else I can go. I don't know what. farther than they can shoot. Bad. Oh no. Yep, straight through.
I'm following your tracks!
Ow! He shot really fast. Almost out of the woods yet. Get it? You get it? No, you didn't get the joke, really? Damn you guys. Laugh at my jokes, they're supposed to be funny.
Lord Harrington's body. He was killed by a shot to the forehead. My health is deteriorating. I need to dress my wound.
Well, how do you do that with a bunch of rocks and snow? Jeez, man. Making stupid decisions. Let's just get the hell out of here. I mean, I don't know what led to this, but it must have been something pretty astray. Well, it should be one of their cabins. Can I please have a gun and shoot them? I don't know who they think they are to shoot Sherlock Holmes. There's a bunch of bloodstains.
I can hide here. I can hide here. The Quartermain Club. This must be Lord Marsh's cabin. This will help to dress my wound.
Alright.
Breathe, Lord Marsh. It's almost over.
Who are you?
George Erst from the First Lovett Scouts, here to deliver justice.
What?
An old soldier. How ironic. Did we refuse you on our special education program?
It's true, I was refused. An old wounded soldier is useless to you. But he can still be dangerous.
We hunted a lot in these woods, but I didn't expect to become the prey. I have lived a grand life without any limits set by others. I will die a happy man, so you won't see me begging you, festering witch.
Yes.
Prepare to meet your maker.
I should decide what to do before leaving the cupboard.
Oh. You've got to make a decision? Vengeance has killed one more scapegoat for her own failures. He's going to take the law into his own hands concerning. It's definitely personal motive. So let's fix that. There's definitely personal motives. Alright. I need to. Now I have to choose. I'm gonna go with that. Condemn. Send Georgia to asylum. He is set by the dangerous criminal. Absolve Sandra Santoria for proving he did not be held responsible. That. Wait. No. Banish is trying to hunt down the sponsored participants. Yes. That's what I'm going with. You know what? I don't know if anything's wrong with him in his mind, but.
George,
no,
lower your rifle, please, for Tom's sake.
Holmes! My, an almost worthy opponent.
Tom? My Tom? If you've endangered my lad in any way, you will pay dearly.
I assure you that Tom is safe in London with a well-trusted friend. Now it's time to end this.
By all means.
George Hurst, your bloodlust ends today. You should have been apprehended weeks ago, before you killed Strobridge out of jealousy. Drop your gun. You may have wounded me, but I won't miss you.
If I ever had you in my aim, I wouldn't have merely wounded you.
Oh. The best detective in England.
Detective, take a look here.
What the?
This is how you became sick, Lord Marsh. The beheading of your victims who were suffering from tuberculosis was what infected you. Poetic justice. I was wrong.
The best detective in England.
Enough!
Well,
you'll
listen.
Die here, Lord Marsh, and you'll die slowly.
Just don't let it happen.
Mr. Hurst, you've already served brutal justice to Lord Harrington, and I hope Lord Collins and Dr. Fisher. Taking that into consideration, you may as well kill Lord Marsh and end the Quartermain Club completely. No loose ends.
Holy crap. 2% of people. Guilty. Huh. Alright. Yeah, I accept. Should I replay it as? No. Alright, I'm gonna end the video here. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, drop a like to let me know and subscribe. And I will catch you guys all in the next video. This is a really fun game, and I can't wait to play more. Peace out, everybody. Thanks so much for
watching. They said one based on the earlier sighting.
What now? Bitch.